I really had to concentrate, but I'm not sure if it was just my stomach. But I think I heard something. I'm not sure, though.
I don't know. It's just nice to take a moment to be quiet and listen to the soil, but who knows what you hear? I don't know. Our little signature of who lives here, what this ecosystem looks like underground. Okay. I don't know, when you ask a scientist what they've discovered, it's such a hard question, because you need. It's like a long story.
Sorry.
Oh, great. One of my favorite things to do is to listen to my husband explain what I've discovered. It's like almost too good to be true. All of the nutrients are being taken out of the soil and put into the fungal network and fed to the plant. And this horrible CO2 greenhouse gas that's in the atmosphere is being fixed by plants and going underground. And those fungal networks, they help plants not only move carbon, but give them nutrients and protect them from heavy metals or make them healthier plants. Okay, from center?
North.
Yeah, up center and up. Yeah? And so he kind of tells all of the things that the plants get out of it, right? That we can see, like, look at, the plants are healthy because of the fungi. But it's a different story than my narrative, because I'm really interested in why the fungi do that. That maybe it's not about the plants, that maybe it's the fungi that are just using the plants to get carbon, but the real action is happening below ground, and that's where they're fusing with each other and they're competing with each other and they're interacting with bacteria. It's like a big opera underground.
Can I just stuff it?
Yeah. Hey, number one. Okay, let's go. We know that there are sort of basic things that these fungal networks have to do. They have to collect phosphorus and nitrogen because that is the currency of trades. They pick it up and they move it through this network, and in exchange for those resources, they get this really fatty, wonderful, sugary carbon, right? They get sugars and fats from the plant. And they can't live without that carbon. So they've evolved strategies to try to maximize those gains from plants. So they have a language and they have a strategy, and it's kind of up to us to understand how it works.
soils don't sample themselves.
I think studying fungal behavior now is more important than ever because the soil systems that keep these fungi alive and that system that keeps everything above ground alive is disappearing really fast. So I launched Spun in 2021. It's a science-based organization that was founded to map and protect mycorrhizal networks. And so to be able to do that, we need to know where they are. So we work with local collaborators and communities to try to map out the mycorrhizal fungi and their ecosystems all around the world before it's too late. That's a deep one. Oh. Okay. Perfect. This is one of the last remaining high altitude grasslands in Europe. And so that's why we really want to know what soil fungi are here. There's very different fungal communities right at the border between trees and grass. Totally different type of mycorrhizae here. So, to me, seeing this grassland for the first time, it's incredible. Yeah, that's the most rich so far. That's a very rich, very, very chocolatey smell. This is the kind you'd want to make a sandwich out of. This is delicious. So good. Okay, next spot. I was studying mycorrhizal fungi when I was 19. I had left university to become a field biologist. I thought that I didn't need to be in school and that if I really wanted to be a proper biologist, I should leave my university and just go live in the jungle and actually study how things work. So it was a pretty naive way of thinking about science.
Oh yeah, look at all that mycelium coming up.
This is fungal country. We can use science in a way that we haven't used it before, that we can see the unseen. Our lab is the first to sort of visualize what these networks look like as they move nutrients and carbon below ground. And so That caught people's attention. They'd never seen flows. It's like watching ocean currents, like a river, but a river moving in two different directions. Once you dive in, it starts to really blow your mind. Thanks, Lorenzo. That's beautiful. That's great, Rocket. It's almost like a galaxy because every little square centimeter, you can have billions and billions of interactions and species happening at once. So you can do these kinds of small manipulations to start unraveling, to get a feel for how a fungus behaves. So for example, if we just really up the carbon supply, are the fungi able to take that and use that in a productive way, grow a bigger network, gather more resources, or does it just lead to clogging of the whole network? We don't know what's going to happen under rising carbon conditions. And so you do these tiny experiments where you just manipulate carbon levels and see what happens. Or slicing them, like really just intense cuts that right across till they bleed out. I mean, it's heartbreaking, right? They just kind of, when you see it being cut and they just lose this bit of flows, and then how long does it take for those flows to be restored? This gives us a chance to actually study fungal strategies, to think like a fungi, to say, okay, well, if I was on this resource landscape, if I was trying to grow, how would I grow? Would I grow towards the nutrients, or would I try to make a network really fast and colonize all the lands and then start moving nutrients, right? You have to kind of put your head in the space of what it's like to be a fungi. Is anybody gonna taste it?
I wanna taste it.
Okay. So rub it between your forefinger.
Okay. Gotta find some good patch there. And then just lick it off.
Yeah, I like ice cream.
I don't taste anything. I think I didn't take it.
Didn't take enough. Now your hands are wet. Nut. This is kind of, yeah, it's like bark.
It just tastes like coffee beans.
Oh, it's covered in dirt.
Oh, that was a big bite.
It's really...
It's a bit of sandy, too.
It's very sandy. You're good at this. Everything I'm just repeating. Everybody has some kind of sign and flyers, yes? So one of the biggest goals is to try to get these flyers out to the general public so they understand the importance of fungi in soil systems. So, right, the UN is suggesting that 90% of soils are going to be degraded by 2050. So that's like within our lifetime, that's really soon. And so we're trying to get out there and understand how the fungi keep soil systems together, how they stitch together ecosystems underground to keep everything above ground alive. It's a new solution.